Hello. In this video, I will give you a brief overview of the possibilities and way of working in Laravel Livewire. In this demo application, I will show you a full CRUD. It's possible to sort the data by clicking the header. Searching can be done via the search fields, and the search is a debounced search. It is possible to change the number of shown records and paginate them. It is possible to search and clear your search. You can add a record by clicking the plus button. After the completion of the form, the input is validated and stored to the database. You can delete a record with a prompt to ask you if you are sure. And last but not least, you can alter a record. All this is very snappy without programming any JavaScript. The first thing we did was sorting by clicking the table header. This action is wired by a click action. When we click on the header, our sort by method will automatically be called in our backend. The sort by logic is executed, in fact, inverting the sort order property of our component. When this logic is done, the render method is automatically called and the users are refetched from the database. And our view is automatically updated. Our view is fetched and sent to the frontend. The debounced search is done by debouncing the wire model. This two-way binding takes care of sending our changed data to the backend. Here changing the ID property of our search object. I've specified default values for this search object in the backend. The render method is called automatically after this change. And so our apply search method is also called, retrieving the users by our specified search. For testing purposes, I've created a simple query with the query builder. This can be done better by using a specific filter method. So after this search, the users are returned from the database and the view is returned to the browser. The roles dropdown is populated straight and blade, like you would do without Livewire. When you click the clear search button, the clear all method is called from the backend. This method, in fact, resets our search values to the default ones and calls the reset page on the Livewire component. By calling the reset page method, our pagination will be reset to the first page. If you click the plus button, the edit method is called with a null value. The edit method is used to create and update a user, making it easier to manage your code. If the edit method reset the value of edit user to true, this will be fetched by our frontend and the edit user component will be shown, showing us the create screen. The same screen is used for editing a user. As you can see, all this feels very familiar. Okay, I have to admit, it's not all without JavaScript. The confirm box shown if you want to delete a user is via JavaScript, but it will also feel very familiar. By clicking the button, a Livewire emit is fired and catched by the JavaScript portion of Livewire. Here we execute a bootbox function to show a confirm box. When we click the edit button, the edit method of the backend is called with a user ID. The user is fetched from the database, the edit user property is set to true, and the edit box is shown. The default Laravel pagination works with Livewire. No changes are needed. When we change the pagination count dropdown, we change the property in our backend. The render method is called with the new pagination count value set, and we retrieve less or more records. If you want more possibilities in the drop-down menu, you can change the possible counts array. If you want more information about Livewire, you can read the blog post on my website. This demo application can be downloaded from my GitHub site. It is fully functional with an SQLite database. Thank you for watching.